How'd you like the command module RCS temperatures?
Houston, they all look very good. The lowest temperature was 40 degrees, and we're taking a look at your cabin temperatures now.
Yeah, we agree on the CMRCS. No heater is going to be required by a country mile.
We think that's correct.
We don't like those heaters anyway, working off the direct coils.
Roger.
Peculiar thing, Owen, on the platform alignment is that when I really take my time and do a very slow, careful, precise job of marking, I'm getting about the same star angle difference as when I'm doing it in TTC and have to do a hurried rush job with relatively poor tracking. Star angle differences seem insensitive and almost make me believe there's a very small bias error somewhere in the section.
Roger, 11. Perhaps the 3 degrees per second just isn't that much of a bother, over.
Well, he's really trying to explain why you can't get all zeros.
Yeah, that's, I think Buzz is probably right. Matter of fact, one time I made a mark which I thought was a little bit in error, but I thought, well, heck, I'll go ahead and see how it works out anyway, and I got 5 zeros that time. And when I have thought everything was exactly precisely on, I have consistently been getting 0.01.
Al, Roger, apparently it pays to hurry.
I usually do. Visibility through the telescope has been very poor. It's, I would say, even worse than the simulator is right now. It requires long periods of dark adaptation, which most times are most inconvenient. So it's really a tremendous asset to keep the platform powered up at all times and to keep it tweaked within the capability of the sextant field of view.
I understand, Mike. 11 Houston, checking your temperatures. Does look like the spacecraft may have cooled down perhaps 2 or 3 degrees in the last 24 hours, and that sounds to be consistent with your report on the comfort level there. Over.
Okay. Is that a limb off phenomenon?
Houston, it looks like we'll have to think a little more about that, as to whether it's a limb off or some effect of being out of lunar orbit. We don't know, so we'll have to puzzle before we can give a better answer.
Okay. Well, and if the systems guys have anything they want to chase down, we'll be happy to give you any readings or reports or what have you.
Roger. We'll think about that and see if there aren't some other tests to be usefully performed here. 11 Houston, be turning things over to the Green Capcom at this time, and see you on the ground tomorrow.
Okay, 11, I want to thank you and the whole Purple Maroon group there for a good job helping Apollo 11.
Thank you, sir.
Thankful to all of you. We really appreciate it. Great job, you guys.
Roger out.
Astronaut Bruce McCandless has just relieved Owen Garriott as capsule communicator. At 174 hours, 14 minutes, Apollo 11 is 103,440 nautical miles from Earth, traveling at a speed of 5,713 feet per second. Thank you.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead, Houston, Apollo 11.
11, this is Houston. With reference to your subjective evaluation that it felt cooler inside the spacecraft last night, we reported earlier that we did indeed see a drop of about 3 degrees over the previous night. Looking back, it appears that the crew of Apollo 10 reported similar feelings during the translunar and trans-Earth coast phases. We were wondering if you could give us any indication of the relative amounts of free or condensed water in the cabin last night and the night before, from which we could infer humidity, over.
I think that might be a little bit difficult to do. We're going to take a look in the tunnel now. It does seem as though during the dirt we've had a little bit more moisture in the tunnel. Of course, since the limb hasn't been there, than we did transmitter.
Roger, we were more curious about the relative amount of moisture between, say, last night and the night before, both of which would have the limb missing.
More moisture in the tunnel now than there has been at any previous time. Subjectively, we have been unable to determine any change in any buildup in humidity. There appears to be no moisture any other place in the spacecraft. For example, the windows are not fogging, or and the various other cool spots around the spacecraft, all of them appear to be completely dry.
This is Houston. Roger, thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 174 hours, 35 minutes. Apollo 11 now, 102,286 nautical miles from Earth. We crossed the halfway point in terms of distance at 174 hours, 24 minutes, and 7 seconds. The briefing on the Lunar Receiving Laboratory is scheduled to begin at MSC in Building 1. We'll tape record any conversations with the spacecraft, play those back immediately following the press conference. This is Apollo Control at 174 hours, 36 minutes. This is Apollo Control at 175 hours, 42 minutes. Apollo 11 is now 98,512 nautical miles from the Earth. The velocity, 5,892 feet per second. During the preceding press conference, we accumulated about 7 minutes of taped conversation, which we'll play back for you now.
The greens are in good shape. The actual green team has been here for several hours, but we're dogging the watch down here to position Ron for entry. Over.
All right, understand. Did Dave Reed get to explain the lunar sphere at the press conference?
No, but your comments about Phil Schaeffer and the explanations were quoted in the paper last night.
Uh-oh.
Do you want to say anything more while you're on the line?
He's right. He's absolutely right. How's the old flight, Bruce? Did he ever let you go get a cup of coffee when we were over on the backside?
Oh, things have been going pretty smoothly down here. He's really not that hard to get along with.
Yeah, he must be mellowing.
Well, we've only got two of them back there right now.
They always used to make me sit at the console through the backside pass, just for training.
The word we have here is that that was because whenever you came back, you had to be retrained.
Touché. Apollo 11, as a matter of curiosity, on our 70-millimeter cameras, we figure we exposed around 300 in the LEM and around 1,000 in the command module, and both cameras, or all the 70-millimeter cameras, work just fine.
Okay, very good. Thank you. This is Houston, over.
Go ahead, Houston.
11, this is Houston. You all have changed Lima to your entry operations checklist dated July 23, over.
When?
July 23.
I'm not sure that we, I don't know how long enough to think going up.
Okay, if you've got the entry operations checklist handy, then I'll pass it up to you, over.
How can you make changes after this stuff? Today don't mean June?
Negative. Just came up today, over.
You're the first to get to us. Go ahead.
Okay, on page 6-1 of the entry ops checklist, down toward the bottom after main deploy push button, we have three additional steps we'd like you to accomplish. The intent of this is to reduce the oxygen pressure in your manifold and to eliminate the oxygen bleed flow through the potable and wastewater tanks during descent. Over.
Okay, we've got 6-1 up.
Okay, Now at the bottom, you've got 10,000 feet, main parachutes deploy, main deploy, push button, push within 1 second. And after that step, we'd like you to insert surge tank O2 valve off, repress package valve off, and direct O2 valve open. You copy?
Okay, down at the bottom after main deploy, push button push, surge tank O2 off, repress package valve off, direct O2 on.
Roger. And then down at the very bottom of page 6-2, where you see direct O2 off, verify, delete that step completely. Over.
Roger.
And for record purposes, this would be change Lima. Over.
Okay, we got it. Now, how far open do you want the direct O2 to be open at this point? And I guess you want to just leave it open from that point on?
Roger, it should go all the way open, and you can just leave it on from that point on. The intent is to completely depressurize the oxygen manifold. Over.
Roger, copy.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. For your information, the All-Star game has just ended with the National League winning 9-3 over American. Over.
Roger, thank you.
And I have a message here for Mike that says, quote, all the chinch bugs are gone, unquote. Over.
Having done their job, I guess.
Well, along with one tree, it turns out.
Yeah, I heard about that. That was right before the flight.
Right, that big storm.
This is Apollo Control. That brings us up to date with the tape-recorded conversation. We'll continue to stand by for any further communications with the spacecraft. During the previous conversations, you heard Mike Collins toss a couple of good-natured barbs at Flight Director Cliff Charlesworth. Collins was a capsule communicator on Charlesworth's shift during the Apollo 8 mission. At 175 hours, 51 minutes, Apollo 11 is 98,034 nautical miles from the Earth. Thank you.
11, this is Houston. Are you still up there? Over.
Not quite as far as we were a while ago.
Roger, we concur. We just wanted to make sure that we still had good comm with you. For general information, 11, you are now 905,970 miles out from the Earth. Over.
In our own backyard.
Say again?
Right in our own backyard.
Roger that.
Starting to come downhill a little bit now. What's our velocity?
The velocity is 5,991 feet per second.
Thank you.
And you are indeed coming downhill.
This is Apollo Control at 176 hours, 44 minutes. Apollo 11 now 94,961 nautical miles from Earth. The velocity has just gone over the 6,000 foot per second mark. We're 6,029 feet per second. The next item scheduled on the flight plan is a television transmission. That's scheduled to occur at a ground elapsed time of 177 hours, 30 minutes, which would be 6.02 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Among the clocks counting down or up to and from significant events here in Mission Control, we have one counting down to entry. And that clock now shows 18 hours, 18 minutes, and 12 seconds until entry. Re-entry is scheduled to begin based on no further mid-course corrections at 195 hours, 3 minutes, 5 seconds. At this time, it appears that mid-course correction 7, if it were done, would only require 2-tenths of a foot per second. Based on current tracking, we wouldn't expect to have to do mid-course correction 7. However, the tracking will be continued, and a decision on mid-course correction 7 will not be made until closer to the time of the maneuver.